Hey guys, it's me, your girl, Carolina Diamond. I thought I would come over here. Is on the top chat. No, I'm not on top chat. Thought I would come to you guys and upload my dinner. I was gonna just upload a video. I said, well, you know, I've been live all day for other people. Let me go live for me and mine. So it's hot and it's finally cooling off and I'm ready to eat. So tonight for dinner, I'm thinking about how to cook southern fried steaks with rice, with gravy, stovetop, with maybe some squash or something good to eat. Y'all, come on, put this thing on our live chat. We're going to head to the kitchen. We're going to make this happen, y'all. It's too easy. First of all, guys, I already got the meat already going. I got to plug my laptop and take you guys with me because I've been charging it all day. And, guys, if you have not subscribed to Jesus Freak, please go to his channel. Like, subscribe, share him out because he's trying to get him a cigarette. Now, guys, I've been sitting on my behind all day. Yes, I have because it's too hot to anything. And finally, we're in the 80s because it's been 100-something degrees today, okay? But basically, what we're going to do in this kitchen today, I know you guys can hear me because I got on my game headphones. What you guys know, I'm a gamer. But today, we're going to game in this kitchen, all right? So what I've already done is I already took my cube steak out already. And basically, guys, what we're going to do is, as you guys can see it, first of all, I have to clean my meat. It's going to be so easy. We're going to keep it very simple. But first, I have to drain my book. Always washing me, guys. I don't give a damn what nobody tell you. Wash your meat because you have no idea where that meat's been processed at. And who wants bloody meat? God knows. I like mine straight up. Bro, what's Albert and Stella? Yes, honey. We're gonna cook this steak, grilled steak, rice and squash. Something good to eat, honey. Finally cool off, honey. And I was at Roy and Becky's travels. Told Becky that you know, say prayers because you lost your bird. And she's like, I miss Alberta and Stella. I said, no, honey. I talked to her in my life. You know what I mean? We all close over there. And I said, because, you know, she's back home because she just had some kind of a surgery, some procedure done. So Roy is in Arizona, Grand Step, and Becky is back in Indiana. So I told her, I said, yeah, I see you. Alberta lost her bird. Pray for it. She sends her love. But anyway, getting back to this, how you doing today? Is everything okay? How's the dog? And Stella. How's the dog, Stella? Doing right now is washing this meat, okay? And it's gonna be real simple, guys. I'm gonna wash my steak. You guys see the steak. I love to clean my meat. I don't care what nobody say, I'm cleaning my meat. And it's hot, y'all, so bear with me. I'm gonna have to do this real quick to get this on so I can chill out. I am cooking four cube steaks. That's all right. Nothing big. You go to your local market, local butcher. If you're in your bake it up, I mean, not bucket it, I'm thinking about Germany. Your butcher, no matter where you are. Overseas or here, y'all get me put this on. I'm gonna read the chat, okay? Because it is hot already. I know what I'm gonna do. Ronnie, go in there, get me that fan. I gotta get some assistance for my help here. I don't know where he went to, but it's hot. Ronnie, go get me the fan on. It's hot. Go back there, give me that fan. The fan. It's hot in this kitchen. He's watching on John Cena, y'all, so I'm not going to bother him because he's just getting out working, working hot sun all day. So, you know, you got a girlfriend, boyfriend, significant other that works in the sun. I understand, honey, it's not easy working 100-degree weather, even though I'm a soldier, retiree from the military. Now, I tell you, I've been places where you don't want to go. It's so hot, honey, but like it's literally hot as hell. I don't know how the hell it is, but, you know, I ain't trying to go there, but shit is hot enough for me here. How about that? Now, with that being said, ladies and gentlemen, two people in the building, one thumbs up. I'd like it so kindly if you give me thumbs up because it takes a lot to go through hot flashes and it's been 100 degrees all day to come in the kitchen, finally cooling down and cook some steak on top of the stove. But it's going to be an easy process because I'm trying to get this thing over because I'm hungry and I don't want to sweat. So what I'm going to do is, guys, I already washed my meat, so I'm going to put it, thank you, Jesus, there's a God. Cool. Oh, y'all see that fan going on over here? Yes, Lord. Yes, right there, what I needed there. Yes, a man knows exactly how to keep a woman cool so he can get something to eat on her. Still, you know what I'm saying, honey. So, but, you know, even though I'm washing me, guys, what I like to do because, you know, I don't like these bloody meat. I hate it. God knows. I'm just one of those vegetarians. You're like, oh, my God, is she vegan or does she really like meat? I only really want meat, and that's a cow. And sometimes some fish without the bones in it because I'm losing the shellfish. But, guys, I'm going to go ahead and see what I'm doing now. And what I'm doing is literally patting the meat with a paper towel so all that drainage blood is gone off my meat because I can't stand it, honey. And then in the meantime, when I'm doing that, I'm going to throw it away because I don't like bloody meat. I'm not a vampire, y'all. I'm just a woman who likes steak, okay? But that is a quick way to do it, guys. See there? And I got my little handy trusty. Guys, if you go to the store and you get these little plastic bags, you're always good with using recycle. You know, you think to my guy ain't got no trash bags. But guess what? Sometimes you use one of those trash bags and put them on your little kitchen cabinet. You save a lot of money by running to the grocery store all the time. Who want to do all that? It's too damn hot for all that, right? But I tell you what, guys, give me one just a minute. Put these headphones on. I got to get some more paper towels. I got that paper towels. Right back. One moment. As you can see, I have my paper towels. Okay. First, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Oh my God, it is so hot. Take it off. Okay, guys, I'm gonna put my headphones in. I hope you guys can hear me. I'm not trying to talk too loud because I'm just switching out paper towels, guys. And then always, what I'm gonna do next is go ahead and wash my hands out to make any contact with me. My mother is a USD inspector for agriculture for the last 40 years, and I've learned a lot from her. Matter of fact, I have her took a test when she first became in the USA as the inspector because my mother, believe it or not, she's very smart, but when it comes to test, she's like, she had to take a test, but she knew that she wanted to become a USDA inspector. My mother, I took the test for her, had flying colors for her. My mom became USDA inspector when I became a sergeant in the United States Army in 1988. That's the day I left and went to basic training, y'all. But anyway, getting back to the meat. See, the meat is already, as you can see, is already cleaned properly. You guys can see it. That's why I need my tripod in here, but time constraint, we're going to go ahead into the thing. So the things I'm going to use in my meat, it's very simple. I use the basic, honey. I'm going to use, see, this is why I got to let these headphones go.